Assalamu alaikum, my students. This is my second lecture on modernism. So we are going to discuss the characteristics of modernist literature, and then we are going to analyze a few of the excerpts from known authors and are going to identify the presence of these characteristics, which I'm showing you on the screen right now. So the characteristics of modernist literature are interested attempt to break free from tradition, interested in the human mind. Well, the major characteristics are interested in the human mind, often experimental in form. Modernist literature shows instead of tells, that is important for the reader to interpret and bring their own emotions. A stream of consciousness writing, run on sentences, lack of punctuation, little or no capitalization, written in the open form and discontinuous narrative. Juxtaposition, two unlike things are put next to one another. So as I've already discussed a few of these in my last lecture, now I'm going to move on to the tone and style, and then we are going to analyze a few of the excerpts from these modernist writers and see how they have incorporated these characteristics into their writing. So if we talk about the tone and style of modernist writers, the tone in modernist literature is often pessimistic and dark. Modernist authors were often born into flaws in society. The style is fragmented, non-coherent, and non-linear. So you have this sense of despair and darkness when you feel these writers, and they are pessimistic in approach, means they're not very positive, hopeful, or energetic while writing. Rather, you perceive a kind of sadness when you read their writing. This is one of the pieces from James Joyce's Portrait of an Artist. It is one of the classic piece from modernist writer, and let's read how he has written. He returned to Mercedes, and as he brooded upon her image, a strange unrest crept into his blood. Sometimes a fever gathered within him and led him to rove alone in the evening along the quiet avenue. The peace of the gardens and the kindly lights in the windows poured a tender influence into his restless heart. The noise of children at play annoyed him, and their silly voices made him feel even more keenly than he had felt at Clongowes that he was different from others. He did not want to play. He wanted to meet the real world, the substantial image with his soul so constantly beheld. He did not know where to seek it or how, but a premonition which led him on told him that this image would, without any overt action of his, encounter him. Now, if you critically analyze this piece, you're going to see there is this despair and sadness throughout the write-up, and the feelings of the character are being discussed. And you see that the character is in complete sadness, plus the character is in a kind of ambivalent and confused state of mind. So you usually observe this confused state of mind in a lot of characters displayed in modernist literature. And this is one of the reasons behind this, is that these writers lived in an era which was post-war era, and this post-war era had an impact upon their thinking and their belief system, which is quite visible in their writing. So when you read these writings by modernist writers, you see that there is continuous feeling of sadness which prevails throughout their writings. The next characteristic is mainly poetic, but we are going to evaluate it and relate it little to prose as well. A poetic movement in modernism, which originated in 1912 and represented by Ezra Pound, Emmy Lowell, Richard Aldington, and other American and British poets. As I've already told you, this was mainly the poetic character trait. Yet we are going to analyze it in prose as well. It aimed at the clarity of expression through the use of precise visual images, initially written in the French form known as imagism. So now we are going to see how imagism is used and written and adopted by the writers in prose. During the first part of summer in Black Rock, Uncle Charles was Stephen's constant companion. Uncle Charles was a hale old man with a well-tanned skin, rugged features, and white side whiskers. On weekdays, he did messages between the house in Carisport Avenue and those shops in the main street of the town with which the family dealt. Stephen was glad to go with him on these errands, for Uncle Charles helped him very liberally to handfuls of whatever was exposed in open boxes and barrels outside the counter. He would seize a handful of grapes and sawdust, or three or four American apples, and thrust them generously into his grand nephew's hand, while the shopman smiled uneasily, and on Stephen's feigning reluctance to take them, he would frown and say, "Take them, sir. Do you hear me, sir? They're good for your bowels." Now, this is again from Portrait of an Artist, where Stephen Dedalus, the main character, is being presented. And here we are going to look at the imagery or the imagism that is used by the writer, how the reader is being able to image whatever the writer want to convey. And what kind of senses has he used? He has used sight. He has used tactile sense. And he has used feelings and emotions to display and make the reader imagine and go through those emotions. So this is another characteristic of modernist writers. Now, when we discuss about a stream of consciousness, I have picked up this excerpt from Virginia Woolf's The Lighthouse. Let me read it first, then I'm going to explain it to you. They did nothing but talk, 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 eat, eat, eat. Women made civilization impossible with all their charm, all their silliness. Now, usually when you read novels, these kind of things are the dialogues, which are in inverted commas. But Virginia Woolf had a different style of writing. She does this interior monologue, where she goes into the brain of the character and write the thinking of the characters in words. Let's read this. Here, actually, Woolf tries to make readers understand about the mindset of males for females. She shows his inner frustration. She lets the readers know exactly how Charles Tensley is one of the characters from the novel, feels about dinner parties, women, and civilization as a whole. Woolf, in the novel To the Lighthouse, does not show the stream of consciousness of the particular person himself or herself, but also through the consciousness of other persons. Interior monologue is also used by various characters in the novel, and it is largely through the twin devices of stream of consciousness and interior monologue that is seen in various characters, so readers can see the consciousness not only through the character of Mrs. Ramsay, but also through the consciousness of Mr. Ramsay and the child James Lily Briscoe, Mr. Tansley, and Mr. Banks. Now, let me explain it to you. What Virginia Woolf, the writer, the modernist writer, has done, she has picked up this new style of writing where she goes into the mind of the character, and whatever they're thinking at that point in time, she writes it in form of dialogues. So this shows opinion, belief system, and thought of her characters. And it becomes more interesting when you read such kind of writing. But if you don't know about a stream of consciousness, it becomes pretty difficult for you to continue. Thank you, students. Here I end this lecture.